what to say. And I depend solely upon you to visit us. I'm not just being the speaker, I'm the healer tonight. And my job is just to hear. My job is just to hear. And you use my lips of clay to speak what you are saying to all of us. None of us would be exempt. And we thank you for it right now. And let everybody put your hands together and give God thanks. He is so good. Before you take your seats, I'd like to give honor to Pastor Martin, to all of the people that are represented in here, all the bishops and pastors in this place, evangelists and teachers and anointed men and women of God. I'd like to give God praise for you. And why don't the whole building give God thanks for all of the women and men of God. All of the women and men of God that are here tonight. Yes. Yes. And to our radio host, she is amazing. Where did she go? Just that quick. She is just amazing. Thank you so much. Why don't we put our hands together for her tonight? Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I was going to do something that I don't normally do until practically the end of a meeting. But I feel led to do it in the beginning of this meeting. And because I believe that everything that I do and where I go, I sincerely and wholeheartedly pray and seek the Lord. Because I am not an itinerant speaker, and I just don't do things now just because the door is open, because every big door is not a blessing. And every invitation is not an appointment. So when you answer an invitation and it's not an appointment, then instead of you being a mouthpiece for God, you end up being an entertainer. And so I'm very cautious of this next leg of my ministry. And I had a very unusual experience, if you would call it. And if you would just give me a minute to just take my time and explain this. And because I've been preaching since I was 12 years old, I don't think I need to convince nobody tonight that I can preach. You know, sometimes we get all up in Adam and we want to convince people. I've been preaching since I was 12. If you wake me up in the middle of the night after I just got through eating some greens and fried chicken, I can wake up preaching. You say I need a word from God, I will get up and just go for it. Because that's just the nature of how the Lord has made me. And so for that reason, my consciousness in ministry now is to make sure that I am not just preaching to entertain, but I am being the mouthpiece that God has called me to be. And sometimes it takes God a minute to get us to the place that he is trying to get us to, but eventually he does. And as I began to dissect, and sometimes I don't know about other preachers, but in my journey, I have been on a journey with the Lord, and he and I have had some interesting moments, and they have been some very real moments. And for that reason, I don't preach what I've studied. I don't read my Bible to preach. I read my Bible to live. Oh, I just said something right there. I don't read my Bible to preach. I read my Bible to live. And so the preaching comes out of what I have lived. And so because it comes out of what I've lived, it gives life. Every time I repeat it or get an opportunity to repeat it, I already know what it's going to do. I don't have to, even with me talking now, I don't even have to shout. I already know that because of my life experience, when I walked in this building, somebody's life is being changed. Oh, I just said something right there. I walked in this building. Somebody's life was being changed.
Because the devil is afraid of me. I don't run from the enemy, he runs from me. And I wish I had somebody to say something like that. I don't shake at the devil's tactics. He doesn't make me nervous. I have located the thief. The scripture says that when you locate the thief, he got to pay you back seven times. If the thing that he put his hands on, not only does he have to put it back, but he have to add six more times to it. That's how you get people sometimes. They are somewhat discouraged because of the works of the devil. And they are kind of, you know, bent out of shape when the enemy starts raging. But I've learned that when the enemy starts raging, like that, whatever he's touching, that's what God is going to use him to multiply. And so that's why the Bible said that in everything give thanks, because this is the will of God concerning you. Because it is the will of God that he would bless you. He said, I know the thoughts that I think of you, and they are good and not evil. And I'm going to give you your expected end. And so if that's God's thoughts about us, then he got to use somebody to get us blessed. I'm not hearing y'all talk back to me. And I can't think of a better candidate than the devil himself. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing. But when he started acting up in my life, I said, bring it on. Because the Bible said when you complete this cycle, glory, hallelujah, then I know I got something coming at the end of this. So you can do whatever you want to do and hurry up and do it so that the Lord can get the glory out of this. Oh, y'all, somebody better check yourself tonight. You better turn around and tell three people he's going to get the glory out of this. Oh, yeah, tell three people he's going to get the glory out of this. Tell somebody the devil cannot the fool all he wants to, but when he gets through, God's going to get the glory out of my life. Preach you under a seat. And I think they can outpreach me. And that's a real mother. Because you're supposed to want your children to be greater than you. Not less than you. And if you've done your job, you've got nothing to be jealous about. They know somebody. And only spiritual parents that are jealous of their spiritual children is when you live with regrets because they're doing something that you knew you were supposed to do that you didn't do. I don't have that problem because I done did everything. I went around the world most twice. I can tell them how to get around the world and come back. Name a country, I can tell you, when you get there, don't do that, don't do this, don't do this, don't say that. So I'm excited that the Lord has given me real sons and daughters in the gospel. Real sons and daughters in the gospel. Real ones. And I appreciate that. God bless you. I want to say, I was dealing with, and I was asking the Lord this, and really, really, really plowing through and asking the Lord, how do we get not only in the supernatural, but how do we live there? Why do we visit, but we can't stay? And why is it that the supernatural have a tendency to feel like a special event when it should be a natural way of life? Like, why do we act shocked when God does stuff? Why do we think that things that we ask him for, he can't do it? Why do we judge God like that? Father, we act like, I want you to do this, God, but this is something that is so big until, Lord, help my faith. And I think that we're living in a generation where this generation have become more acquainted with the works of the devil than they are with the works of God. And they become so comfortable, I say comfortable with, I was telling somebody this the other day, I said we become so comfortable with always battling the devil until we really don't understand the concept that there is a place that you can go to in God where you're battling him. Jesus picked fights with the devil. He wasn't hijacked by the enemy. Everywhere he went, he stirred up something. He messed with something that the enemy had planted. He transformed the minds of people that the enemy thought he had in eternal unbelief. And he did it with simple faith. He did it with walking out and teaching the word and seeing all of the host of people that were hungry. And he did it by just simply feeding them. And then he opened up the blinded eyes, and everything that the enemy had put in place to be a permanent, Lord Jesus, things that the enemy put in place to be a permanent, those are the things that God takes pleasure in unnerving. And what he does, people of God, he waits until the enemy has not only titled it, but he waits until the enemy seals that thing as if this is supposed to be the rest of your life. Or whatever you're dealing with right now, this is the way that it's going to be. And so, you know, your uncle was like that, or your auntie was like that, or ain't nobody in your family never owned that, and ain't nobody in your family never had this and never had that. And so the enemy starts planting a lifestyle in our heads and making us think that this is a permanent state of mind, when it's just a temporary place that God wants to tear down and prove himself to be God. So then when I look at the people, when I look at the people that God used in the supernatural, and I have to take my time and really plant this. People that God used in the supernatural before the Holy Ghost failed. We got all this power now and doing less with it. But before the Holy Ghost fell, what was it that made people in the Bible days experience the supernatural in a way that we don't experience it today, and they didn't profess to have the Holy Ghost? They did not profess to have the Holy Ghost. They had something that was very, very, very unique, but very simple. They had an ear inside their ear. I'm going to say that again. They had an ear inside their ear. In other words, my ear, the Bible says you will have ears and you won't be able to hear, and you have eyes and not be able to see. But these people had an ear inside of their ear. In other words, they had the ability to hear from God. I'm going to say it again. They had the ability to hear from God. I'm not trying to make you shout. I'm trying to plant something. I'm trying to record something. Because when you hear something repeatedly, all of a sudden your spirit man will record that. And so when you go out of this place and God starts talking to you, your inner ear will come open, because he's plowing it open with this word right now. I said he's plowing it open with this word right now. Because many of you in this building don't even understand that you are on the brink of something great. But it's because you cannot hear. It's because the enemy has clogged your ears up with so much that you cannot hear the details of what God is about to do for your life. And not only can you not hear, you cannot perceive that. Because you cannot convince yourself that God is going to do that for you. Because you of what other people think. I'm not hearing y'all. But the people that God do it for is a people that don't want you to have it. I'm not hearing y'all say nothing. But when you got an ear to hear God, your best friend. Now I'm going to say something here. When you got to get to hear God, you ain't got to depend on no prayer partner. I'm not hearing you. Because half of the people that you're praying with are not even on your level in the spirit. Half of the people that you are interceding with don't have a clue of the realms that God is taking you into. And every time he takes you somewhere, you got to spend hours trying to explain to them what God is saying. I'm not hearing y'all. But God is calling us as individuals to be able to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to my church. Sometimes I can tell you when you really done heard him. Because when you really hear him, when you really hear him, you almost afraid to really repeat what you just heard. Because you know, Lord Jesus, if I tell somebody that God said he getting ready to take me all around the world, they'll think I done lost my mind. I'm not hearing y'all talk back to me. Because see, some of us miss our miracles because we talk too much. Some of us miss our miracles because we tell it to the wrong person. I'm not hearing y'all. Some things we miss is because we put it in the spirit realm for the enemy to hear it. I'm not hearing you. He's not all hearing. He's not all knowing. He's not all seeing. When I can hear God, then I'm confident in my aloneness. When I can hear God, I'm confident in my aloneness. When I can hear God, I'm not afraid to walk by myself. When I can hear God, I'm not afraid to stand on God's opinion about me. When I can hear God, I'm not hearing y'all, I'm able to move in what God said. When I can hear God, it may sound crazy to you, but I'm walking by faith and not by sight. Small things. It starts with, don't go down that block, go down this block. And he said, why the Lord got me going all the way around there? Because when you get to this corner, park your car and go in this store. Y'all ain't saying nothing. See, I just had that experience the other day. I got on a train and I had to go take care of some business in Baltimore on Sunday. And I got on the train. When I got down to the platform where the conductors were, I got on the 4 o'clock train only to realize I was on the wrong train. And I was going in the wrong direction. So they took me off of that train and they put me on another train and said, you're gonna go back to Baltimore now. When the conductor walked up to me on the train and said, man, where are you going? I said, New York. And I said to myself, why did I just say New York? He said, your ticket's at Baltimore. I said, but no, I'm getting off in New York. He said, ma'am, are you sure? I said, yeah, I'm sure. He came back through. And I was saying to myself, well, maybe I need to go on to Baltimore. And all of a sudden, I started feeling nauseous. And I said, okay, Holy Ghost, what you trying to say? Because now you causing me to be sick. What did he say? Do not go to Baltimore. Get off the train in New York. And when I got off the train, where I would have got off the train at the time that I got off the train is where everything was exploding in Baltimore. Because when you can hear, oh my God, when you can hear God, but you gotta be willing to hear him. I said, you gotta be willing to hear him. Because the majority of the time, when he speaks stuff, it's gonna go against your intellect. It's gonna go against what you think. It's gonna go against what you feel. But you gotta trust him. So what is it that causes us not to be able to trust him? I'm going somewhere with this. Trust what we hear. Why can't I trust what I hear? Okay. So we got some people over here, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. We got some people over here that this thing got me because when I started reading this, have you ever just, you kind of dealing with some things and you saying, well, Lord, Well, when you gonna fix this? Because when you fix this, I know da 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 da. And so the Lord said to me, I want you to read the Bible. So I started reading. And I started reading about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And he said, the thing that I want to point out to you, where this is concerned, little lady, he said, I want to point out to you that these are people that are doing works of the supernatural in captivity. Lord Jesus. He said, these are not free people. I'm not hearing y'all. Because y'all say, well, look, well, you know, the Lord, get me out of this. These were people that operated in the supernatural in captivity. I'm not hearing. They were brought into another land as slaves. In other words, I'm not hearing y'all. They was brought into another man's land. They had to sleep where they was told to sleep. They had to walk where they were told to walk. But the only thing they could not control is their ability to stand steadfast in the principles of God. They could not take that away from them. I'm not hearing y'all. So we get ready to do away with all the excuses that says, if God does this, then I can have this. God can do it now. God can give it to you now. God can use you right now. And I said that and I felt the power of God. I said that and I felt the power of God. The devil got us sitting up here waiting because I'm here to tell you right now. Good God have mercy. It is your experience with God that brings you power. I'm not giving up. It's not because you sit there waiting. And whining. It's when you walk, even when I am in captivity. Why are you doing that right now? Because, watch this. Why are you doing that right now? Why are you operating in this right now? Why are you doing that right now? I said, because this is the best time to do it. Wait a minute. The best time to do it is to do it now. Because if I listen to this, if I wait until everything is right, I get to take no prisoners. Y'all ain't saying that. But if I do it now, I'm going to affect some other people that's bound up. If I do it now, if I move now, I'm going to bring some other people out with me. If I activate my faith now, this is when your brother gets saved. This is when your sister gets saved. Because why God takes pleasure in taking something that the devil said would never be right. They stole them from their country. Had them in another land. Watch this. Had them held captive somewhere else. Lord Jesus, them captive people get stuff done. Come on. I said, them captive, remember the little girl when the master got sick? She said, I know a prophet. She was held captive. Y'all didn't hear me. She was a slave. She was a slave, but she did not lose her prophetic connection. Good Lord have mercy. She was in a strange land, but she did not lose her ability to connect prophetically. Who am I talking to? God talking to somebody, because you got to get out of your flesh, and you got to get in the realm of the prophetic. You got to get in the realm of the prophetic. You got to get in the realm of the prophetic. I can say that 15 more times, because I don't think you're listening to what God is saying. You got to open up your mouth and let God use your mouth to prophesy you into another dimension, even though I'm in a strange. This is strange to me. All of this is strange to me. When do I know when I'm getting ready to get my greatest breakthrough? When you ain't got no more connections. Or how do I know? How do I know how to believe God when you ain't got nothing else to believe? I just said something like, oh, how do I know to trust God when you ain't got nobody else to trust? Oh, y'all. No. God ain't trying to hurt your feelings. He's trying to set you up to be able to walk independent of anybody. He's trying to set you up so when you're in your own bedroom by yourself and you ain't got nobody to talk to, you ain't got nobody to depend upon, you can hear God speaking and telling you, move now, because I'm with you. because I'm with you. Because I'm with you. If you move now, I'm with you. Jesus. Because if you move now, at the sound of my voice, I'm going to say this right here. It's the spirit of his voice that will go with you. Because see, some people say, well, I trust God like that. Well, first of all, you know, they had four things. They had four things that God made me study and chew on and chew on and chew. And I was like, God, I get it. He said, no, you don't get it. I said, God, I'm reading. I know what you're saying. They had knowledge, they had understanding, they had wisdom, they had skill. Got that. He said, no, you don't get it. You don't get it. How do you, Lord, how are you saying I don't get it? He said, because you are intertwining your knowledge and mistaking it for your wisdom and your understanding. And now you have become perfected in your knowledge. I'm not hearing y'all. So because of that, you think you got skill. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. I can't get nobody to say that. See, that's the only problem that I have when I'm mentoring people. Because they be like they know they don't know. But you don't know my know. I'm not hearing y'all talk back to me. See, that becomes the problem. Because you, listen, you're skilled in what you know. I'm not hearing you. You're skilled in what you know. But where I got to take you, you got to come on know my know. I'm not hearing you. And so then, therefore, you are skilled in that grade. And that's why in that grade, you somebody. I'm not hearing y'all. And it's hard to leave your somebody-ness. I'm helping somebody. I'm helping somebody. Hard to leave your somebody-ness. Because we thrive in a word he gave me called concupiscence, which means I'm going after something, but I have a wrong motive as to why I'm going after it. Because, see, we thrive to be famous. We thrive because, oh, I want this, and we thrive, and please notice me, and we thrive. But the fault that we have is that the skill we have learned it from an amateur. The skill we have learned the skill of the gift and not the skill of the spirit. Because if you know the skill of the spirit can always teach you out another gift. I'm not hearing nobody say nothing. And that right there was a good place to shout, but y'all missed it. When you got your knowledge, you're skilled. I'm going to say it again. When you got your knowledge, you're skilled. And that's your confidence. That's the confidence that you have in yourself. Somebody said, well, you know, she can show up at them banana puddings. And then you meet, you know, your grandmama come in the kitchen and say, I think you ought to add a little bit. Oh, grandma, I know everybody likes my banana pudding. See, that's that spirit right there. Everybody likes my banana pudding. And your grandmama trying to tell you it ain't got enough. Baby, listen. It ain't got enough vanilla in it. Everybody like it. And so they have to let you go on until the next family reunion. When everybody comes in, where Big Mama's banana pudding at? I made it, said, I don't want you to leave on Big Mama's banana pudding. And you need to go and ask Big Mama to do something for you. Are y'all getting the point? Are y'all getting the point? Because there's flavor in living for God. But we don't want favor. We want skill in the spirit. Because Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had skill where they were. Because the Bible said they were well learned, they had knowledge. But watch this. Watch this. He said, I want you to read this so you can get this. I said, what did he say? Knowledge is information gain. Knowledge is information gain, which means somebody else taught you that. I'm saying something right now. We can't get to the realm of the supernatural because Apostle Kerry, somebody else taught us that. So God's challenge is up against what somebody else taught you.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
gonna give you a perfect example. If a doctor came in here right now, and a doctor had his license to be a surgeon, and he came in here right now, and he'd been practicing medicine for 30, 40 years. But if we said, "Brother Doctor, come on up here and get the microphone," he would be out of his league, because you only got knowledge for what you got knowledge for. But when you got knowledge in the spirit, then you become accessible for things to be downloaded to you that you did not learn. God, I just said something right there. That's the reason why intercessors can pick up conditions. Intercessors can walk in the hospital room and say, "No, this ain't what it is. The doctor said it's this, but the Holy Ghost just told me that it's this right here, and I rebuke it in the name of Jesus," and the person get up and go home. One of my spiritual daughters, her daughter is in the hospital. And the doctor said, well, she had some blood, something that happened to her blood, and she, you know, couldn't barely talk. Her face was numb, and arms and hands numb, and she didn't have no feeling nowhere. And instantly, Easter morning, she just went poop, hit the floor, no feeling, nothing. Rushed to the hospital. And the doctors are saying, it's a rare, 1 out of 100 people get this blood disease. And so they called me, and they said, "Well, prophetess, can you call?" Holy Ghost wouldn't let me call. I said, "Okay, I don't know why the Lord, now you're supposed to pray for the sick, but the Lord was saying to me, not yet." So I went to sleep a couple days, woke up, woke me up at about 3:30 in the morning. And he started talking to me. And he started giving me things in my spirit. So my phone vibrated at about 6 o'clock, and they said, "Can you speak?" And so I got on the phone, and the girl was literally dying. She said, "I want my mother to call you, because if it's my time to go, I want the prophet to tell me." And she's on the phone talking like this. That's all she can get. And I sat there and I said, "No, it ain't your time." I said, "The Holy Ghost said you're going to live." So the mother started praising God. I said, "The Holy Ghost said you're going to live." And the Holy Ghost said, "This is an experience that he's given you, because at a young age, he's going to take you to dimensions that most young people never experience." I said, "The Holy Ghost said, you're getting ready to go in out of the heavens. And God is getting ready to use you prophetically in a way that you have never been used before." I said, "The Holy Ghost said, bear with him, because this is a transition, and he has to have you still so he can download this into you." I said, "The Holy Ghost said, the old you is dying, but there is a new you that God is about to resurrect in the spirit." I started rubbing my hands with that olive oil. She went, and I heard her throwing up. And her mother said, "She's throwing up white foam." I said, "She's throwing up the spirit of death." I said, "I command you to come out." I said, "That foam is the foam of death, and I command it to come out." She kept throwing up, kept throwing up, kept throwing up. Then the Lord took me up in the spirit. And he said, I said, "They're getting ready to try some experimental medicine on you, and it's going to make you sick." And I said, "At first, it's going to look like it's not working." I said, "The doctor's in the bathroom right now." I said, "I see a heavyset lady coming in your room, and she putting this stuff in your IV." I said, "But this lady got a need." And the Holy Ghost said, "When she get in your room, he going to clarify your speech, because you got to prophesy to this woman. Even in the state that you're in right now, the Lord said he's going to use you." So that 2 nights later, that happened. So a person carrier, I'm at home, my God, and I'm feeling death all around. I said, "No, this demon trying to come back." I said, "Wait a minute." I called and I said to her mother, I said, I'm getting ready to pray. And when I got done praying, I said, I'm calling right now for a garrison of angels. Now, I don't have to tell you that if you're going to walk in the supernatural, you're going to be retarded. I don't have to tell you that when you walk in the supernatural, you got to put yourself in a position to be laughed at. When you walk in the supernatural, you got to put yourself in a position for people to think you crazy. You got to be the only one standing in the room saying it. I'm not giving y'all talk back to me. Because when you get it from God, you don't shake at nothing God tells you. I don't care what you're looking at. Says she landed here, she still ain't got no feeling in her arms and legs. She paralyzed from the neck down. And I said, I call her. Now her whole family is in the room. Daddy, brothers, sisters, everybody. I said, I call on folk angels and I want y'all to stand. And I stopped, I said, no, do it now. Do it now. Because I saw it. I said, do it now. I said, I want y'all to stand in all four corners of the room. I said, but two of y'all, I want you to stand on each side of the door. And I could feel them come. I said, but before y'all come, turn around and go back. I want y'all to dip y'all swords in the blood. And I said, now I want you to stand at the door. Any demonic force come after her life tonight, take his head off. I said, keep your sword drawn. The two that's at the door, keep your sword up. Now, everybody listening to me on the phone like, well, what is going on? But see, I don't care what people think, because when you operate in the supernatural, y'all are hearing me. Keep your swords drawn. And I told her mother, I said, y'all can go to bed tonight, because they're going to watch over you. She was like, yes, ma'am. She said, yes, ma'am. I said, God says, all right. I said, spirit of death is trying to come. He's looking up and down the hallway. I said, but he's not going to come. I said, because I can feel him. And so I got up out of my bed and I started walking back and forth. And I said to the spirit of death, I'm going to walk as long as you walk because I know you love him. Now, y'all ain't saying it. Because Matthew, the 24th chapter, the 43rd verse says, if the good man of the house had known what watch the enemy was coming, he would have watched. I'm not talking about with eyeballs. I'm talking about with your spirit. I'm not talking about with your eyeballs. I'm talking about watching with my spirit. In other words, when my spirit gets troubled about something and my spirit is trying to speak to me about something, I don't ignore what my spirit is. I kept walking. So the next night, her mother called and she said, prophecy. Can I call you? I said, okay. She said, it just feels cold. I said, all right. She went to the desk. She said, I want y'all to move my daughter out this room because it seemed like can't no heat get in here. The room just feels cold. And I said, mm-mm, that ain't it. I said, it's the spirit of death. Come on. Spirit of death. So she said, they argued with it. And then finally the nurse said, well, I'll move her. So they moved her down the hallway, across the hall, three doors down. I told the angels, I said, go with her. Go with her down at home. Well, how about the very next night, the person that they moved in that room died? No, you don't hear me. You don't hear me. I said the very next night, the person that they moved in that room died because the spirit of death was coming for somebody in that room. But I have authority in the spirit, you don't hear me, to put angels as charge of over what God has given me to intercede for.
Screaming to the devil saying, think I found you. I called her mother with that robe on. I said, I done found him. I done found him. I done found him. I said, because the devil would have had us praying for a blood disease when really God had to reveal to us what it is. I'm not hearing y'all talk. once you spoke it. Wait a minute. So that means you can read the scripture that says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. And you can say, that's sweet. But if you don't know the original intent of what the speaker was saying, if you miss the revelation, you miss the spiritual travel. Because you can't travel in the spirit of a knowledge. You travel in the spirit of a revelation. Now, I just said something right there. I don't know if anybody getting this. I don't know if anybody getting this. Because I told you I came to teach you something. You travel in the spirit of a revelation. That's why God has to be revealed to us. That's why his presence has to be revealed to us. Are you hearing me? Because once you get the revelation about something, you have the authority now to go in the spirit with that. You're knocking at a door of knowledge. Satan, come on out of here. I feel you, devil. You better take your hands off. Take your hands off. And stop hitting this hard mouth. Take your hands off. Take your hands off. And when the Holy Ghost said, no, they acting not like that because that's a spirit of rejection. But they, okay, I just located the thief. And now when you say, you spirit of rejection, I break you right now. Then that's when you see the person just breaking down. And then you go and say, uh-huh. And I come after you spirit of prayer. Because it's that spirit of knowledge that God gave you through revelation that allows you to step up in the spirit. And once you get in there, you can rip the enemy down. Once you get in there, you can plow him out. I'm not hearing nobody talk. But you got to know how to get in. You can't get in. Speaking. So then if I don't know what this, watch this, if I don't know, I know what I read, but if I don't know what the spirit is saying, then I don't have understanding. Then I'm left confused. Then I'm left walking the flow all night long crying. Because I don't have understanding. Now, I'm saying something right here. See, because somebody's going to go to bed tonight and go to sleep. I don't hear nobody say nothing. Because when you get understanding, you can lay down and go to sleep because you know. You know what? This right here is a trick of the devil right here. This right here ain't nothing but Satan himself. And when he show up like that, honey, that time that I'm praying and the enemy will come, I've seen him physically come and sit on my other couch. And I learned, I turned over to give Apostle Carrier and said, not tonight. Not tonight. And rolled over and went back to sleep. You won't sit there by yourself tonight. I'm not hearing y'all talk back to me. Y'all get stuck too much attention because you don't have understanding. I will converse with you. Spirit of darkness, I will converse with you. When there is something that the Lord would have me to learn of you. But if the Lord is not entreating me to speak to you, I said not tonight. Just because you manifest don't mean you get my attention. I can't get nobody to say nothing. Just because you manifest don't mean you don't get my attention. Now some of y'all, that went over your head, but I'm gonna bring it back down on your lap. Because see, some of the stuff that be manifested in your family, it don't get your attention. Now, I just said something like that. Some of the stuff that you're dealing with is the enemy trying to manifest himself because he want to throw your focus off. Because God is about to do something for you. And he already knows that he can't stop what God is about to do. So he got to bring the distraction. You got to say, not tonight, not tonight, not now, not tomorrow, not next week. I'm gonna bless God because you just revealed to me that I'm that close to my miracle. You just let me know that God is about to do exceedingly and abundantly above all I can ask or think because you just showed up.
Intent. I know what he means about me.
I'm not confused. The devil comes and says, you ain't nobody. You ain't nothing. Wrong one. Because I know the original intent. Y'all understand that. When the enemy starts talking to you about your children, that's what you need to tell them. Wrong house. Because I know the original intent. That everything that comes out of my loins is going to know God. Everything that comes out of my loins is going to serve God. I'm not hearing y'all talk back to me. That's the thing that Shadrach and Abednego had. They would not change their testimony. My God, I just felt that. They would not change their confession. I don't care what they were facing. They would not change it. That's why they said, if my God don't deliver us, he's still able. We fall in a pit with he's still able. We fall in the fiery furnace with he's still able. I'm not hearing y'all. You got to practice this. You can change your confession.
If he might do it, ain't he gonna do it? My mother said, Papa, where you get that kind of? It's like a tenacity. I said, because once I get the revelation. They told her, they said, we're getting ready to go and put her in a coma because we want to let you know she's going to die. And all hope is gone for you. They told them that. They said, all hope gone, we're going to put her in a coma so she won't struggle while she's trying to make her transition. She said, prophets, what you think? I said, they ain't putting her in nothing. Because if the Lord going to take us, we're going to be woke. I ain't hear y'all talking about them. Wait, if I ain't got nothing else to get by the doctor's will, we gonna stay woke and see his coming. If that's what he gonna do, you ain't gonna put her to sleep. Tell her we just gonna go and lay down early. No, her eyes gonna be wide open. I'm not hearing y'all. Y'all better come over here and say something. No, that's what the doctor said. That's what the lawyer said. And that's what the teacher said. The teacher said, my son, he had a learning disability. They said, He ain't gonna never go to high school and he ain't gonna never graduate. They said my daughter never be, and y'all let all that junk get in your spirit, and you got a program where it constantly play like a tape recorder in your head. And the reason why God brought you here tonight, because he came to give you another tape to play. I'm not hearing y'all. He came to give you another tape to play. That my God is still a healer. My God is still a deliverer. Person. I ain't hear nobody talk back to me. Listen, I feel that on this side over here. You got people in this building that have been to hell and back, and you gonna let the devil tell you something about never? You ain't even supposed to be in this building. You ain't even supposed to be alive. I'm not hearing y'all. You should be somewhere crazy. You should be somewhere dead. I'm not hearing nobody talk to me. The devil won't tell me never when I done already been to hell already. Your levers don't carry no weight. Your levers don't carry no weight. You said I would never make it and I'm still here. You said I would never come out of it, but I'm still here. You said I would never have a right mind, but I'm still here. And that's why I take pleasure in looking you in your face and calling you the liar that you are. Because you love to use a word that you have no power to make manifest. What are you talking about? Somebody ain't gonna miss. Every day I tell her mother, I said, expect something today. She said, expect something. I said, expect something. Expect something. The prophet's what you see. I said, I don't see nothing, just expect. I said, expect it because I'm expecting. Y'all ain't saying that. She called me on the phone saying, prophet, she hollering right now because electricity is going through her. And the doctor said, that's her whole body coming back. I said, I told you to expect it. I told you to expect it.
What are you talking about? She's going to walk out of this hospital. What are you talking about? No, y'all ain't saying nothing. Let me tell you something. Confession is free. Come on, I just said something right there. I said confession is free. And the problem with y'all is you so used to paying for everything, you don't even know how to take advantage of something when it's free. It costs you nothing to speak the word of the Lord. It costs you nothing to declare what God is saying. It costs you nothing to put in word.
And God is free. It's free. It's free to say I'm healed. It's free. Don't cost you nothing to say that. Don't cost you nothing to say that. It's free. It's free. Say I'm healed. And deliver, transform. My greatest days is ahead of me. My worst days are behind me. And God, I just feel that all everything I said, I felt that for you. Your worst days are behind you. Your best days are in front of you. But the way you're gonna get the sidewalk, the way you're gonna get the pavement to walk in your best days, you gotta spit it out of your mouth. Your walking grounds come out of your mouth. That's why some of y'all can't move. Because you haven't spit one out. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. It's that all day long. God done did the work. But how do I move from the place that the work has been done into walking in the work that's been done? He's already worked out one piece of sidewalk. God giving me the victory in one piece of sidewalk. I shall be the head and not the tail. Whoop. Another time, I'm able to walk. I'm able to walk. I'm able to walk. And you don't stop walking till you get them words behind you. Say, ah, you ain't going nowhere. You don't make you that. Yeah, then you turn around. You turn around and walk in a pavement that you've been walking all your life. And that's a pavement of defeat, depression. Who am I talking to? Sickness, unbelief, fear, doubt. Who am I talking to? It's time for you to turn around and begin to walk in another pavement. Begin to spit out what God said. Begin to speak those things which be not as though they were.
See, I'm going to give you a secret. Give you a secret right here. Give you a secret today. See, this is a secret. And I got this about 2 months ago. It was the beginning of March. I was reading, he said, go back and read in Genesis. I was like, okay. Start reading Genesis. He said, all the Bible scholars. He said, I created man in my image. And he said, then I blew into man the breath, blew into his nostrils.
Yeah. Come on.
The breath of life.
Yeah.
And it didn't say, and man became a life. Pastor Carrie, Andrew said, a living soul. And I said, okay. So the Lord said, pray. And I just started praying. Praying the scripture, I started thanking God for it. Andrew, he said, now be quiet, but let me tell you something. I said, okay. He said, I want you to really know. Okay, he said, no, all of me is in man. He said, now go look up. He said, go look up mammoth. Go look that up. Go look up mammoth. And I started looking up mammoth. He said, let me tell you why. Why he's called man. He said, because everything that I create that was an animal, a beast, human being, I created them to be spiracles. And I looked the word up. I'm telling you, there's some stuff you can know and there's some stuff he can just tell you. You'd be like, what? He says spiracle. I looked the word up, spiracle, S-P-I-R-A-C-L-E. It's spelled the same way as miracle, but instead it's spiracle. And when I looked up spiracle, it said a being that had the ability to take breath in, and the breath that it takes in, it has the capability of breathing it out. And I said, okay, God. He said, what I'm trying to tell you is that when I breathe my breath, I put a spy in you. And so when I breathe into you, y'all ain't saying that. The thing that I show you while it's in you, you're supposed to breathe it out. And you don't have to tell nobody how you got it, how you found that out, because there's a spy in you. There's somebody that, oh, y'all, that's in you that's telling you secrets. Get that. Y'all didn't get that. Because, watch this. I just told you that. And because I just told you that, I just woke it up in you. Hold up, Oshaya. Stuff that used to be hid from you, God gonna start telling you. Because y'all, come out here. You got a spy.
Got that thing in you that you in prayer, you go. Yeah. And then you go. Don't go to them people's house no more. You go, I don't think y'all heard what I said. I said he's waking it up. I don't think you heard what I said. I said he's waking it up. I just hit my Holy Ghost and ain't nothing gonna be here from you. And you ain't gonna be blindsided no more by nothing. I'm not hearing y'all talk back to me. Y'all better open up your mouth and say something. He gonna tell you where the discount is. He gonna tell you what dealership to go to. He gonna tell you what hospital to go to. I'm not hearing y'all talk back to me. He gonna tell you who to stop fooling with. He gonna tell you who not your friend. He gonna reveal it to you, because it's spying you. It's waking up. It's waking up. You better tell somebody, I gotta spy me. I said, tell three people, I gotta spy.
Make you feel good. Anytime God touches you, he is eternalizing you. He is doing something that is eternal in you. Did you just hear what I said? Nobody in this room is going to ever be the same. You don't hear me. And see, you know what? Listen, I'm not saying that because I see you respond to it. Because I know that what I'm saying, it goes in a realm that's deeper than you able to react to. Because some of y'all are in the flesh so deep that it's going to take you weeks before this thing, actually erupting your spirit. But God told me to speak it because it's time for you to come out. He told me to speak it because it's time for the yoke to be broken. He told me to speak it because it's time for him to make a way out of nowhere. Who am I preaching to? He told me to speak it because the devil is a liar that he is. He told me to speak it, and you better run out of it. He said, speak it. I'm speaking it in a realm up there that's going to follow you to the grocery store. I'm speaking it in a realm up there that's going to chase you down. I'm speaking it in a realm that you're going to be like Nebuchadnezzar. God going to trouble you in your sleep. Who am I preaching to right now? You better open up your mouth. keys in the spirit, you got to play that key. So don't run the board on me. Don't do all that. No. Find my key, because that's a key of deliverance that's breaking something in the spirit. Help! That's the key. Turn it up from the... Turn it up. Help! That's what I hear being shouted from heaven. Now everybody start shouting. Help! Help! Heaven is resounding that time. Heaven is resounding that time. Shout out of your valley. Shout out of your valley. experience. Watch this, y'all. So that my prayer is filled with the kind of power that it pushed back the spirit of darkness, but it summons the heavens at the same time. I don't think y'all heard that. So because of the experiences that you all have had before you walk in this building, y'all ain't saying that. If you praise him tonight with all of what you brought in this building, you gonna praise God over into skill, which means I done learned how to bless him anyhow. Have to come my shop. I done learned how to give him praise anyhow. Yo, somebody better give it to him. Somebody better give it to him. Somebody better give it to him. Your mouth and get your skill. Come on, this is when it counts. This is when you go to levels of maturity. This is when your faith is increased. This is when you get another charge in your belly. Somebody shout. Talk to me. See, I can't get nobody to go with me this time, Pedro. They just want to go with me when they say that you're coming out. Don't nobody want to go with me right here. Because God want to usher us to a place that when they said we're coming to get your house, we said, at what time? What time is you coming? Because you ain't getting me to throw my spirit off. I'm not hearing y'all. He usher you in that place that when they say they're going to repossess your car, you tell them, meet me on the corner of 9th and 8th. And tell me what time and you can have the keys. And I'm going to shout while it's rolling up. Because I've learned to put my trust in Jesus. Somebody give God a shout. I can't get nobody praising right now. I can't get nobody praising right now. Because what you don't know, that if you're praising right there, you're praising yourself over to a new car. You're praising yourself over to a new house. Hey! Somebody shout! I'm God from Zion. Somebody shout! The spirit of skill. Let me help you with this. This level that we in right now in this building, right this very second, this is the praise that most believers never get to. But this is the praise that declares to the spirit of darkness, it ain't over yet. Somebody better praise it. Oh, shut down the mouth. This is the level of praise. Tell the kingdom of darkness that it may be going on right now, but it don't stop here. It ain't over till God's time is over. Somebody give God a praise. Hey, give God a it ain't over praise. Give God a shifted. My God, I feel it. My God, I feel it. Every time you give it praise, something else is moving. Every time you give it praise, something else is shifting. You better praise him. Praise him out of your spirit. Some of y'all missing it. It's a holy shout. I'm not hearing nobody talk to me. It's a holy shout. Wait a minute. Let me prove it to you what I'm saying. I can prove it to you in the scripture. The Bible says that when Daniel got through dealing with Nebuchadnezzar, he said to Nebuchadnezzar, "For it is the holy ones that come out of Zion that have decided. It is the holy ones that shout that have decided that God is a God that controls the earth realm." That's what the scripture says, which says to me that when we shout while the anointing is present, we are decreeing and declaring that heaven is making a decision with my name on it. Somebody better shout right now. Somebody. Oh, I just heard him say, "You shout while I decide. You shout while I decide." I just heard the Holy Ghost say, "Why you shouting on the side? Why you shouting? I'm deciding. Yeah, yeah. Why you shouting? I'm deciding. Why you shouting? I'm making a decision with your name on it. Yeah, yeah. Oh Jesus, oh Jesus, oh Jesus, you're the Holy One. You're the one that makes the final decision. God, we obey you tonight. We shout for the victory. Hey, hey, hey. Oh God, oh God, oh God. Turn around and tell your neighbor, "I just shifted something." My God. Turn around and tell somebody, "I just shifted something." Turn around and tell three people, "I just shifted something." Tell your neighbor, "I can feel it." Tell them, "I got a witness in my spirit that something in my house just moved. I got a witness in my spirit that something in my church just moved. I got a witness in my spirit that something in my heart just moved." Somebody shout. Oh my God, I hear the Holy Ghost saying, "I'm doing it from the root. I'm pulling it up from the root." You better praise it right now. "I'm doing it from the root." I'm going down to the root of the thing. Somebody better shout, because I'm not praying, y'all. I'm not just telling you to shout. He said he's pulling it up by the root. Who come up a bone shot? He said by the root. Oh, the bone shot that I saw. He come up a bone shot. Come on, you better praise him. We ain't got but 48 hours. You better do this. He ain't got but 48 hours. I'm doing it by the root. I'm coming after the root tonight. I'm coming after the root tonight. I'm digging it out by the root tonight. And I'm burning the ends of it. I'm burning the ends of it. It ain't gonna never sprout no more. It ain't gonna never take root no more. I'm burning up the end of it. You better give him a praise. You better give him a praise. You better give him a praise. Because this enemy that you see, you will see no more. You better give him a praise.
Break up the fallow ground, God. Break it up right now, God. Oh, God, seal us in a place. Don't let us vacillate. Don't let us go back to where we came from. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God, set us on fire. Oh, God, set us on fire. Somebody shout, set us on fire. Somebody shout, set us on fire. Oh God, burn my belly, Jesus. Burn in my belly, Jesus. Burn up my desires, God. Burn up my will, God. Burn up my way, God. Oh God, put a charge in us tonight. Put a charge in us tonight. So we would keep the course, God. God, set us on course. And put a charge in us so we keep the course. Don't let us be turned around. Don't let us be turned around. Don't let us go back to the flesh realm. Somebody give him a praise. God, we don't want to go back. 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 My God, I wish y'all could see what I see in this building. We don't want to go back. 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 We came out here to come out. We came out here to come out. Somebody in this building, I'm hearing the Holy Ghost. You came out here to come out. If I'm talking to you, begin to praise God. You came out here to come out. You came out here to go to another place in Jesus. I want
Crusaders. He delivered. You got people spitting up all over this building and nobody laid hands on them. I said, God is delivered. He sets the time and he sets the place to annihilate every spirit that have tried to kindle your life. And tonight you being cut free. You better give God a praise. You being cut free. I don't even care if the being cut free is religious. You being cut free. See in this place. You're in this building, but everybody that's connected to you is being delivered. They're not even in this building, but they're being changed. You don't know what I see in here. This ain't no small thing. This ain't just no church service. I'm telling you, the devil is a liar. People that are connected to your life, angels are loose right now. You better give God a praise. I say they're being broke free. Hey. I don't care where they are tonight. They could be in the disco. They could be in the club. They could be a crackhead. God said they're being set free by your praise. God said they're being set free by your praise. Alcohol is drying up right now.
Jesus. Jesus, I see your hand. Hallelujah. I see your works in this city. See your works in this city. The door is open. I said the door is open. I'm talking about heaven's door. Whatever you want right now, I said the door is open. Whatever you need right now, you can reach up and get it.
People talk about them, but I have them. I know when he's in the room. I know when the yoke-breaking angels are present. And I'm here to tell you that they're doing a work that you know not of. Take a while. But the Bible said in one night,